One Photoshop hack, which I wish I knew, is that you can create more undo steps, which can be handy if you make frequent mistakes. Simply select Edit, Preferences, and Performance, and then increase the number of history states to any number that you wish, up to a maximum of 1,000. This is great for when you're working in the zone and you forget to save your previous file. However, bear in mind that the more states you add, the more likely Photoshop will slow down.
This Adobe hack is a game changer and it takes full advantage of the rectangle frame tool. Instead of creating frames one by one and then spacing them out separately, now you can create multiple frames that are evenly spaced out, so on a grid, as you press the left, right, up and down keys as you draw up the frame. So this is perfect if you need multiple images on a grid.
My Adobe hack that I wished I had have known sooner, how to change your captions to graphics in Premiere Pro. You can create those captions and they'll be all synced to your timeline. And then you can go up into option, I think it is, and then change captions to graphics. And those captions will still be in sync, but they'll become editable text files. And then you could edit all of those captions and the styling of those captions, because they're now graphics files with different animations. Some could be big, some could be small, they could be all stacked together. I've been using it for like TikTok style, captions and lower thirds and things like that. I don't know, go and try it. Let me know if it works.
Struggling for a spark? Fire up the largest unlimited creative subscription in the world. Find and download authentic graphics, templates, photos, and fonts. Get seriously creative. And go supernova with Envato Elements.
My quick hack is painting using adjustment layers, groups, and layer masks. It's excellent for creating a number of different skin and makeup effects and how I keep a certain level of photorealism in my photo manipulation portraits. So let's say we wanted to add some white warrior face paint to someone. Take a grayscale adjustment layer, then a brightness slash contrast layer to up the brightness and remove the contrast. This is essentially our paint. We're going to group them together, add a layer mask, invert that mask, and then paint using any good old texture brush, using white on the mask. It's a great hack for both people doing really intense SFX type stuff like me, and photographers who just want to add a bit of beauty makeup, lipstick, eyeshadows, things like that.
Starting with something that might sound a bit silly, but it took me years to ask myself if it's possible to replace the default text settings that you get when you add new text in Illustrator. So, as you probably know, any new text that you add uses this Myriad Pro font with a pretty small font size. You can easily replace these settings by going to Window, Type, and Character Styles to open this panel. From the flyout menu, select Character Style Options, move to the Basic Character Formats, and now you can replace the default font settings.
One vital hack to be aware of, I would have to say, is the Select Subject feature in Adobe InDesign. It's very similar to Photoshop's Select Subject function, and this provides a very quick and easy way to wrap text around an object or a person just by outlining it. This is great for designers who spend a lot of time creating publications where text is often placed on top of images.
One Adobe Illustrator hack that I wish I knew sooner is the ability to save a document with multiple artboards into separate AI files. This is especially useful if you want to send each design separately or if you simply want to stay organized. To do this, simply go to File, Save, and then in Illustrator Options, make sure to select Save each artboard as separate file. This will also add a number to each of the file names, which will help you stay organized.